Techpreneur for decades now. I want to know two very quick things. One is today IoT, SaaS, when we're talking about AI, they've become the buzzwords for Indian startups and Indian budding entrepreneurs. Today everybody wants to start a tech company. But in context of what really works for India, what do you think the tech startup ecosystem looks like, and how can somebody looking to start a company in the tech product or services space really establish one?
I think there are several things, right? So I'll pick AI and IoT because okay. I happen to work with a few. So the interesting thing about IoT is there is a lot of buzzwords and there's a lot of hype. That is true. But there are also a lot of real problems IoT can solve. I'll give you a very simple example. Every house has a small peephole. So when somebody rings a bell, you can go and look and to see who's the person on the other side before you open the door. And you look at distorted person and you can't really make out much and all that sort of stuff. And imagine that you just replace it with a small webcam. And then when somebody rings a bell, their photo appears in your mobile device, like very clearly here. So first of all, you capture the picture. Okay. The technology required for doing it is not very difficult. The camera is so small that it can fit into the same place. The person who's come there does not even know that they're facing a camera. So this will give a psychological satisfaction of security to a lot of people. So let us say that I'm not at home. I leave my old mother at home and go away, or we just travel for 2-3 months and nobody's there. Anytime somebody comes there, you can detect the motion, now take a picture. I know every person who has come near the home. And it goes into some Google Drive or OneDrive or something. And so this is a small security device, and it's useful. It may not cost a lot, maybe a couple of $1,000s, okay? It can be easily sold in all places where there is no community with security and all that sort of stuff. So the point I'm trying to make is, you have to identify opportunities that will take, a lot of times people buy things because it makes them feel comfortable. Sometimes they buy things because they absolutely need it. Okay. Another example, which based on some student project, is a gas leak detector. One of the biggest problems I have is I have an 87-year-old mother. Occasionally she goes and turns off the knob, but sometimes she forgets to turn it off completely. There is a small amount of gas leakage. If I can get an alarm, I can call her and tell her, go close it. Or sometimes she forgets to close the tap. And if there is a water leakage, it's a waste. So you can get an alert for that. So what I'm trying to say is that IoT connects the physical world to the virtual world.
Right.
And gives you lots of little tools to manage your life, family, house better. And I think when there is the best way to do it is to do a small prototype. And this should not cost more than a few $1,000s to build a prototype like this. Test it out and talk to potential customers. And then figure out whether you can, what are the objections they have. And this is true of any product in the market. You want to find out, you perceive the product in a certain way, customers perceive it in a very different way. Can you go and get feedback from them and then go through an iterative cycle of improving the product and then sell it? You can say the best test is, hey, can I install it and leave it for 5 days and go? And all I'll do is unscrew that peephole and I'll put it back so there's no damage done. So what happens is, you know, the skills that are needed is not just ideas and product skills or ability to build a prototype, but also find which angle you need to deal with the customer. That's a very important entrepreneurial skill, whether tech or non-tech. So that is very. So the thing is, you may have several ideas. You may think they are useful. Try to find how many people, potential users are there in your local, you know, space, right? Like in your locality, if you live in Chennai, Adyar, you know, how many such units can you sell if you make it? Get that and then start work, and then you'll be able to get a slightly better idea. So for me, ideas come first. You do an implementation, but you validate it, and that is the single most important thing. And you may change your mind during the validation process, come up with a slightly better idea, which is also great. So that is one way. So for your second question, so there are fundamental shifts in technology, right? Just like automobiles change the world, electricity change the world, web change the world, mobile devices are changing the world, AI will change the world. And not because you're going to have things that will replace human beings. We are nowhere near that for several decades. But what will happen is in certain areas, like for example, you already see recommendation systems that when you buy some X, somebody finds out what your interests are based on your interactions and recommend you Y so that I can buy something better, right? So simple prediction, recommendation, those kinds of systems are going to be part of every one of the technologies. So the overhyped parts of voice bots, you know, those kinds of things may be a lot less, but they will also get better.